So I have here 7 hammers. I did not forge these hammers. Andy Doner forged them for me. I hired him. He did a good job. I finished them up, sized them, shaped them, polished them, got them heat treated, handled them. And we thought that they were going to be the prototypes for hammers that we were going to sell on our website, and we still might. But these are different. These are numbered. Serial numbers 1 through 7. They've got our touch mark, Essential Craftsman is stamped in here. They're a 2.5 to 3 pound rounding. It's got a rounding pane and a flat pane, face. They're a blacksmithing hammer, but they would be good in a shop generally, a millwright, or, you know, there's a lot of things you could do with these. But what we're going to do with these hammers is give them to people who have had a tremendous impact on our channel. As we've thought about it, this is the right thing to do. And serial number 1001 is going to my good friend Cy Swan. He is a good friend. Somewhere between a brother and an uncle, Cy means a lot to me, and he's taught me a lot that I could have learned in no other way with the time that I had left in my life to learn. Met Cy 13 years ago, and it gave me a 20-year jump start into blacksmithing. And Cy thinks the hammer's a little small. Cy has a hand like a catcher's mitt and about the same thickness on the hide, and he thinks that handle's a little refined for him. It's all right. He'll tear it off there in no time and have to put another handle on. In the meantime, thanks, Cy. Number 2 is going to a family friend. So the Pitts and the Wadsworths live 2 blocks apart, and our kids were the same age, and Greg's still a good friend, and Kathy's still a good friend with my bride, Kelly, and the kids got along good. Well, when we started this channel, Brian, who's a professional videographer, reached out to Nate and said, "Hey, Nate, I haven't talked to you in years. Love your channel." And so he's been providing coaching for us about cameras and lenses and all kinds of stuff that we didn't know. Brian, thank you. There are 4 YouTube channels that were helping us in ways that we still would have a hard time explaining. And the first of those is Jimmy DiResta. Now, Jimmy DiResta, we located Jimmy DiResta early. And one of the reasons for that is because he was one of the first subscribers to our channel, which was so flattering because, man, look what this guy's doing. He makes the coolest stuff. And he has this wonderful art sense, not only about the things that he makes, but about his videos. And so we're watching those, and Nate's watching them and saying, "Wow, those are great ideas." So Jimmy, thanks for the inspiration. Hammer number 4. Another channel that showed us, in fact, he probably subscribed, I would think, about 2 weeks after Jimmy did. AVE. That guy has a YouTube model like nobody else, and we watched what he was doing and how idiosyncratic and unique his approach to a YouTube channel is, and the things you can learn from that guy, and the way that he's building his YouTube channel has been inspiring. So here's a very cool trick I learned from AVE. You know, hammer handles shrink and the heads get loose, and these might, they probably will, but I'm going to try to minimize this by soaking just the portion of the handle that's embedded into the head, not quite up onto the handle itself, because I want them to look nice, but I'm going to soak the heads with the handles in it in antifreeze, because the antifreeze penetrates, swell that up tight, and hopefully it'll stay tight for a good long time. This hammer, all of the hammers, have been standing in the Prestone, in the antifreeze, for 4 hours. And you can see, that wet line right there? It's soaked up through the head of the hammer and about an inch up the handle. And that's far enough. That stuff will probably stay impregnated in there for quite a while. Not indefinitely, but quite a while. Good move. Thanks for the suggestion, AVE. I like it. All right, number 5. The third channel that Nate discovered before any of these other guys and watched and was talking to me about it, Tips from a Shipwright. He and his team make the coolest, most authentic videos about ships and fitting and wood and really neat. It resonated. Louis, you're doing a good thing, and we wish you guys much success. You can store this right next to Mr. Friendly, okay? Green Beetle, another guy with a channel and an approach to YouTube that was inspiring to us and gave us a lot of insights. He's got an excellent presence. He's just a guy, and he makes the most beautiful knives. And his photography and his imagination about and the heft of his knives. But here's the thing, confession. we did a collaboration with him, and we dropped our end of the deal. Now, we're not done, Green Beetle. Hang in there. And that's one of the reasons we're sending you hammer number 6, is because we feel bad and we're not done making this thing work. But I sent him a Damascus billet, and the darn thing failed. It failed. I don't know why it opened up. I thought the welds were good, but it failed, and I didn't have time to get back to it. So I had Cy make a very similar billet, sent it to him, made a beautiful knife. And he sent me a billet out of nails and powdered, I think, 1084 or 1085. I don't remember what he uses. And I guess turnabout's fair play, because that billet failed too. It opened up. I was upsetting it, needed a little more cross-section, going to make a tomahawk. And anyway, so I just had to set it aside, but we're not done. I'm going to do something with this, man, and I appreciate your patience. And Nate has made 5 attempts at making a video out of the good footage we've got from this to get something coming back your way. But, and I know you've got good hammers, man, but you might want to use this. So this last hammer is a giveaway. We've done it before. We're going to do it again. The way to get in the drawing for this hammer is to get on our mailing list. You can check that out. Go to the link in the notes. It'll take you to the place that you can fill out the information. If you're on the mailing list, your name's going to be included in a drawing for this little 2.5-pound rounding hammer, flat hammer, serial number 007, Essential Craftsman touch mark on the side. Maybe I didn't mention that. All these things have got our touch mark. Many thanks to our friends and our mentors. Couldn't have done it without you. And thanks for watching.